I'm Zaina Abu Shaban. I'm a 16-year-old student from Gaza, Palestine. Ever since I was a kid, I used to like technology. I got into computer programming 2 years ago when I joined Code for Palestine, which is a scholarship here in Gaza from Palestine Group Foundation. I really liked the experience of learning computer programming because it felt like whatever ideas you had in your mind, you can put them out into the world and you can apply them. In quarantine, I had a project due for Code for Palestine, and I thought, what better idea than to make an app that helps children specifically understand the virus and learn more about it to protect themselves and their families. My area, at least in Palestine, I feel like children don't get enough information about what's going on. So I worked hard on making the app really attractive for children. It took me about a week to get it done, the coding part. So this is my COVID-19 app. It has three tabs. The first tab is the COVID-19 update, the second tab is the tips, and the third tab is the quiz. You get the global count of active cases, recovered cases, and deaths. We can also select a country and see how many cases it has exactly. Now over here it doesn't have Palestine because it didn't find it there, I just found West Bank and Gaza. There actually weren't any cases in Gaza except for this month. Recently, we got some cases that weren't actually in quarantine. Gaza has lots of people in a small space, which makes it really dangerous. After that, we can go to tips. We have three different sections. The first section is five rules of prevention. The second section is immunity boosting foods. And the third section is what to do if you're feeling sick. As you can see, I incorporated some, you know, colorful elements and some drawings. And over here, we have the last tab, which is the quiz tab. We have a quiz for adults. In the adult quiz, we have information that is a little bit more difficult than the kids' quiz. Things that all adults should know about the virus. So, for example, what is the official name of the virus as designated by the World Health Organization? If you put COVID-19, it'll tell you it's not correct and what the correct answer is. And for the kids' quiz, it's basically the same concept, but it's just simpler questions. Also things that kids should know. So for example, how should I cough? If they say cough like this, it'll tell you why it's not correct and which answer is the correct answer. And that's my app. In Gaza, because of the blockade, it's really hard to get, you know, resources to do things. Lots of things don't come in to Gaza, and even if they do, lots of things, they might be expensive for organizations to actually buy. Virtual learning is going to be very difficult since we have electricity problems. So lots of people might not have Wi-Fi right now, so they can't join in on a Zoom call, or they might have to watch recordings, and it's going to be really difficult for lots of them. This is my senior year of school, and I'm not going to experience my last year of school as it should have been. To go back to our normal lives and what we really want right now, we should just take care of all the precautions and do everything to stop this virus. I don't feel like people my age, you know, teenagers, like between the years of like 13 and 18, they don't really have much opportunities to try and, you know, like for competitions or for even classes, or like every time I open something and go apply to for an idea or for a competition, it's usually like, what college degree do you have? So my first message to CBOs and NGOs is to show more support to teenagers and young leaders because they're full of energy and hope, and it's necessary to use this energy for beneficial work for the society. And my second message would be to link teenagers and young leaders to the community's challenges through several training programs such as life skills, strategic thinking, conflict solving, IT. The sooner we gain the skills, the better it is for us and the community. The most important thing is to use the talents that you already have into making this society better. So if you know how to program, then program an app. If you know how to draw, then draw something to do with COVID. And just use your talents to their full capacities to help your society.